Today I'm going to show you how to create a fillable form in Google Docs. We'll include form elements like text fields, drop-down selections, and checkboxes. Let's dive in. Okay, here I'm in Google Docs and I have a form open, and this is the form that we're going to create. I'm going to go ahead and zoom in just a little bit so you can take a look. And here we've made this form a fillable form so that users can come out and type their name in the different fields. And they can select a drop-down list selection. They can come to the different places and select the different city, state, or region. And then they can also check a box, whatever type of incident that they want to describe on the incident report form. And then down here, they can type into this box and type in the description of the incident. And so I'm going to show you how you're going to be able to create all these different form elements in Google Docs. So let's go ahead and open up a new blank document. All right, the first thing we want to do is insert an image or our logo. So we're going to go up to Insert. We're going to say Image, and then we're going to upload from the computer. We're going to navigate where we have our logo, select it, and click Open. Then we can size it down. So we're going to select it and drag it down to the size that we want. And then underneath here, you have different options. We're going to put this behind text. And then with our drop-down selection here, go ahead and select Fix Position on Page. This allows us to grab it and move it wherever we want to place that. And since it's behind the text, it won't affect if we do want to put a title up here, which we do. We're going to want to name our form. So I'm going to come up to our center alignment here, click on Center Alignment, and here's where we're going to type our incident report form. We can select the text here, and we can make it bold and increase the font size. All right, the next thing we want to do is create an area. I'm going to go back to a left alignment here, and we want to create an area where we have a fillable space that a user can type in their name and date. And so to do this, we can insert a table. So we're going to go up to Insert, Table, and I'm going to select four cells of a single row. And here we're going to say name, and then we're going to have the date and time over here. And we can adjust these by simply dragging this cell border over. So we want a little bit less space for the date and time, and then a little more space to type the name. Now what we want to do is hide the borders that we don't want to have visible, but we do want to leave an underline where we want the user to fill in the name. So in order to do that, I'm going to go ahead and select all of the borders. I'm going to hold my control key while I select each border. One thing I can do is actually come up to the border width and set that to 0. And by doing that, it eliminates that border. And I want to go ahead and actually eliminate this one as well. We're going to eliminate that and set that to 0. Now, another thing you can do is change that border color to white. So for example, if you wanted to keep the border there, but not have it visible, you could set that border color to white. So there's a couple ways that you can hide that. I'm going to go ahead and just leave that at 0. So now when your user opens up the form, they can click here and they can type their name, and it will not move or adjust. It will be within that cell and it will be underlined on the bottom border. So that's one way that you can create those text fields on your Google form. Now, the next thing we want to do is create some drop-down lists. So now there's a section of my form that's going to be the incident location. I'm going to select that, bold, and make it a little larger. I'm going to hit Enter, and I'm going to enter a table here as well. I'm going to click on Insert, Table. I'm going to select three columns with two rows. And the top row is going to be my labels. And I'm going to select that row. I'm going to come up here to the background color and select gray. And I'm going to center align. And then I'm going to put drop-down selections in the cells. So to do that, I'm going to come up to Insert, and we're going to select drop-down. And this is going to allow us to add a new dropdown. So we're going to click on New Dropdown, and we're going to call this one Region. And for my first option, I want an option that appears as a default that says, please select. You don't have to do that. If you just want to list your selectable options here, you can. But I like to have that visible so that someone knows to click on it to drop down and make a selection. So I'm going to use that and say, please select. And then my next options, I'm going to fill those in here. And if you need to add a new option, you can just add a new one. And if you want to reorder these, you can just drag and drop them. And if you need to delete one, of course you can. You can also select a color for the button that will appear for a user. So for example, if you wanted to have a slightly different color for each option, then when a user selects that option, then it will be in this particular color and it'll have the text will contrast so that you can see the selection. So I'm going to go ahead and click on save, and then we'll go ahead and add dropdowns for the state and city as well. Now that we have our drop-down list selections, now we want to create a section of the form where we indicate a type of incident. We want to have a checkbox for those different types of incidents. So here's how we'll do that. We're going to create the header here. All right, now we're going to create our list selections, and these are going to include injury, illness, environmental, and a notifiable event. Now what I'm going to do to create the checkboxes, I'm going to select my list and then come up here on your toolbar. You'll see the checklist menu. There's a drop down. There's two different types of checklists that you can use in Google Docs. This one is the one we want, and this one allows us to check a box and have that selected. Now the other option, if we were to choose that, would actually cross off the item that you check. So for example, if we selected that one, it would cross off the item. So you want to be sure that you select the correct option and use that for your checkboxes. Now the final section of our form is just an open-ended area that people can type in a description of the incident. So we'll create that using one large cell. All right, so I have my cursor where I want to insert that. I'm going to come up to insert. We're going to do a table and just do the one cell. And so here we can actually drag and adjust the sizing of that so that if we want that to fill up the rest of the page, it just means that users can come out and they can fill in information and type into that text box. Now you can format the text the way you want it to appear in that text box. So you just have your cursor and select that. And if you, want it to be a little bit different color or a different font or just not bold, you can do that. We can adjust the sizing so that when someone does type a description, it would be the format that you select for that text box. So likewise up here, you might want to bold or make larger some of the elements of your form format so that it's a little more obvious, and then keep the formatting unbold where people type in the information just so it differentiates for you. When you get your forms back, you'll easily see when people fill in the form. And you can test your selections here. So for example, if we select East, you can see that the color shows up with the right font contrast. Now, one thing that happened was our image got pushed down to the bottom of the next page. So we're just going to bring that back up right here and place it where we need it. Now, two things to note and keep in mind when you create a fillable form in Google Docs. One is that, unfortunately, you're not able to protect the document or restrict it to just filling in the form fields, which means when a user accesses this form, of course, they're going to come in and fill in the form, but they also have the ability to accidentally edit or delete, possibly delete elements of the form formatting. So just keep that in mind. That's one of the limitations of Google Docs for fillable forms. And then the other thing to note is that unless you have Google Workspace, a work version, you're not able to save this as a template. So what you'll want to do is every time that you want to use this form as a new form, you're going to want to come up and just say File, Make a Copy. And so you're going to want to keep your base document as your template. And then to use a new form, you would just make a copy and title that as you need to, and it will save a different version of that fillable form for you to fill in. If you want to learn more about creating fillable forms, be sure and check out the playlist on my channel. You'll learn how to create forms in Word, Excel, Acrobat, and even online forms like Google Forms and Microsoft Forms. Be sure and share this video with your friends and visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.